Hi, thanks for taking the time to join us for this webinar. It's my pleasure to introduce Dr. Mike Murphy, who has a wealth of experience advising scientists and clinicians on optimal breath collection and biomarker analysis.
Thank you for the introduction. In this short webinar, we'll give you an overview of the science behind breath biomarkers and explain how you can incorporate breath biomarkers into your own clinical trials. As illustrated here, simple breath tests could soon help doctors detect early signs of disease and make better informed treatment decisions. Every breath contains thousands of volatile organic compounds, or VOCs. We'll introduce you to what these VOCs are, where they come from, and why they are promising non-invasive biomarkers for everything from cancer to infectious and inflammatory disease. We'll show you how breath biopsy is being used to address two fundamental challenges in healthcare today. First, detecting disease earlier when better treatment options are available and more lives can be saved. And second, enabling precision medicine to ensure that the right patients receive the right drugs at the right time. So which VOCs are present in breath, and where do they come from? The thousands of volatile organic compounds in exhaled breath are fundamentally metabolites produced by the body. Endogenous metabolites are the end product of gene transcription and protein expression. What makes metabolites very interesting as potential biomarkers is that while our genome can tell us about the risk of getting a disease, it's our downstream metabolism that gives us the best real-time snapshot of what's actually happening now. As such, the identity and concentration of metabolites provides relevant information about actual disease activity because they most closely resemble the phenotype of an individual. It's worth bearing in mind that, as well as endogenous metabolites, breath also contains volatile compounds from other sources, such as the food that we eat, the air that we breathe, the medications that we take, our lifestyle, and our microbiome. All of these factors together mean that the VOC profile in our breath reflects our entire phenotype, providing a detailed and comprehensive insight into how the body is functioning. When the body's functioning changes, VOCs are well suited to detect these changes early and provide information on the way in which these processes are changing. The fact that the profile of VOCs in breath reflects both our endogenous metabolism as well as external environmental factors is highly relevant when considering the utility of breath biomarkers. In cancer, for example, both environmental exposures and genetic changes are closely linked to the onset and progression of disease. Environmental factors and oncogenes can both lead to mitochondrial dysfunction, which brings about metabolic changes in cancer cells. Cancer is a good example of disease changing the body's metabolism. We've known for about 100 years that cancer cells have an altered metabolism, even at a very early stage, which is crucial when you're thinking about early stage detection. Cancer is characterized by rapid growth, which means the cells have altered metabolic requirements. Mitochondrial dysfunction in cancer cells causes them to metabolize glucose differently, which is referred to as the Warburg effect. This involves a disruption of the normal citric acid cycle and a switch to an anaerobic pathway. This metabolic change results in two survival benefits for the cancer cell. First, it can function in an oxygen-deprived environment, and second, the altered metabolism provides metabolic intermediates that serve as building blocks and fuel for cancer cells to grow. These changes in cellular metabolism and the resulting alteration in the breakdown products of metabolic intermediates lead to changes in the profile of the exhaled VOCs. So, measuring VOC biomarkers using breath biopsy offers researchers and clinicians a powerful way to detect, diagnose, and monitor disease based on a patient's own metabolism. So how do the VOCs get into exhaled breath? Many come directly from the airways tissues, but many other VOCs come from the bloodstream. The lungs are incredibly efficient at exchanging volatile compounds between blood and alveolar air and on into the exhaled breath. While a traditional blood sample analyzes just a tiny fraction of your whole blood volume, our breath biopsy platform samples breath over a period of time. So it's a bit like getting a window into a much larger volume of blood. Once every minute, your entire blood volume circulates around your body. Every minute then, VOCs originating from throughout the body reach the lungs, where they pass efficiently from the blood and into the exhaled breath. Using our breath biopsy platform, we can continuously sample breath over this time period, collecting VOCs from throughout the body. With each exhalation, we trap and store the exhaled VOCs, pre-concentrating them on sorbent tubes for later analysis. This provides two important advantages. First, this gives us unparalleled sensitivity for the detection of disease biomarkers. And second, this enables us to identify biomarkers relevant for diseases occurring anywhere in the body, not just in the lungs. As breath contains VOCs originating from throughout the body, this means breath biopsy is relevant for a wide range of diseases, either for detecting and diagnosing disease, or for deciding on the most suitable treatment. This figure illustrates some of the diseases for which potential VOC biomarkers in breath have already been reported in literature. In order to identify really robust breath biomarkers that can be introduced into the clinic, breath analysis needs to be incorporated into clinical trials. One of the challenges in the past with breath analysis has been, how do you collect a high-quality breath sample in the clinic? This is where our Receiva breath sampler comes in. Receiva was developed to enable patient breath samples to be collected reliably and reproducibly, making it ideal for large clinical trials. During sampling, patients just breathe normally while Receiva tracks their breathing pattern and captures selected breath fractions. Over a period of time, Receiva traps and stores the VOCs and pre-concentrates them onto sorbent tubes, which are a bit like vacutainers for breath. These tubes are then sent to the lab for analysis. Receiva is currently being deployed in studies at over 90 clinical sites and hospitals across Europe, including the world's largest breath-based clinical study. At the heart of breath biopsy is the FAMES microchip chemical sensor. We originally developed the FAMES chip for the detection of toxic gases and explosives, and FAMES is now deployed globally in a range of industrial and military applications. We have taken this well-established, proven FAMES technology and incorporated it into our Lone Star VOC analyzer to provide an extremely robust and reproducible platform for the detection of VOC biomarkers in breath. A key step is taking the rich FAMES spectral data and analyzing it to identify potential new biomarkers. This involves first identifying features, then developing a classifier, then refining that classifier, and finally evaluating the classifier's sensitivity, specificity, and statistical significance. Our data scientists have developed a machine learning approach for breath data to train algorithms and develop classifiers. The most straightforward way to include breath analysis in your clinical trials is to use our biomarker services. You simply rent a Receiva breath sampler. We provide full training for the trial nurses to collect the breath samples. Then you send the patient breath samples to our breath biopsy clinical laboratory, and our experts will take care of the entire analysis, including biomarker discovery, test creation, and validation. You pay per sample for the samples you send us for analysis. As part of our biomarker services, we may use our proprietary database containing thousands of anonymized patient VOC profiles to verify the classification algorithm in silico. This can provide you with early evidence of likely clinical relevance without the need for additional samples or studies. If you're considering initiating a new study, we do offer assistance with the setup and study design to ensure from the start that your project is optimally designed to deliver the answers you are looking for. Whether you're looking to identify novel breath biomarkers for diagnostics or precision medicine applications, such as therapeutic response, patient stratification, or drug toxicity prediction. Alternatively, if you prefer to do the analysis yourself, you can of course purchase the Receiva breath sampler and Lone Star VOC analyzer and integrate the breath biopsy platform into your own lab. I hope I've given you an insight into how breath biopsy can be used to identify volatile metabolites in breath and discover novel biomarkers for early detection and precision medicine applications across a wide range of diseases. To learn more about how you can integrate breath biopsy into your clinical trials, visit alstonemedical.com to download our complete guide to breath biopsy, or get in touch to arrange a discussion with our experts. Thank you for listening to this webinar.